for that I have written this sequence. Follow this sequence, okay? So based on priority, I have written these things, okay? I will explain what is the priority and when the priority will come into play, okay? So now, remember this sequence: interrupt 0, timer 0, interrupt 1, timer 1, serial port interrupt. And beside them, you have seen some addresses, okay? 003H, it is an address. What address, sir? ISR address. ISR means interrupt service routine. So a small program to solve this interrupt will be available at this particular address, okay? So that is meant by this ISR address, okay? So if timer 0 interrupt has occurred, how to overcome or how to solve that particular interrupt? So for that, an ISR will be available. Where it will be available? It will be available at this particular address, okay? Similarly, you have ISRs for all the interrupts. Now see this interrupt 0 and interrupt 1. So I have marked with black ink here. Okay, these are what hardware, external hardware interrupts. So you can see the pins INT0 and INT1. Okay, now in that, how to enable these interrupts? Interrupt enable 1, interrupt enable 0. So interrupt this enables. So if you want to enable these things by programming, okay, using the instruction set or clear, you can enable these hardwares. But you can set these things, but to clear them, what will happen, sir? They are auto cleared. That means while servicing the routine, okay, while servicing the ISR, so while moving to that part, you will auto clear this thing, okay? IE0 and IE0 will be auto cleared. So we have seen these things in flags of timer 0 and interrupts, okay? These are also called interrupt flags, okay? Now coming to timer 0 and timer 1, once again these two are also having what flags, TF1 and TF0. These are interrupt flags, so you can enable using set instructions, but and clear using instructions also. But what will happen, sir, when the timer overflows? Suppose timer 1 has overflown, then TF1 will set. When it is set, what will happen, sir? You will interrupt the processor, and while moving to ISR, you will auto clear. You will clear this TF equal to 0, TF1 equal to 0, because after servicing the routine, if you come back and if you see TF1 equal to 1, that means it has set. Once again, you will jump to the ISR. To avoid that thing, what we are doing, sir, simply while moving to ISR, okay, while moving to ISR, then we will clear this thing. So that is what auto clear, that is the meaning of auto clear. I hope you have remembered the concept of this timer overflow and interrupt enable. Okay, I have drawn the ISR diagram to explain you that part. Okay, now the third thing is what? Okay, first thing is interrupts, timers and serial port. So this has a ISR address of 0023. So where it is available, sir? It is available in SCON register. What are the flags available for this one? TI and RI. What TI stands for? Transmit interrupt, receive interrupt. So we have seen in serial code, while transmitting 8-bit data, processor will place the data in SBUF. Okay, then what will happen? It will send the data, and if it becomes empty, it will interrupt the processor using TI and mention that please send next data. We have seen all these things in the previous class. We have seen how RI bit is used, RBA, TBA. There you have clearly seen that what is happening. There you have seen clearly how these interrupts are set. And RI, coming to RI, what will happen, sir? If you have received 9th bit as 1, that means the data is valid, and because of the validity, RI will be set. Okay, if it is valid, then only RI will set and interrupt the flag and say some data is available in SBUF, please take the data into processor. Okay, now the interrupts which are having some fixed ISR address, you can see all these 5 interrupts are having some fixed ISR address. So such type of interrupts are called vectored interrupts. Okay, all these things are called vectored interrupts. Okay, and coming to the last interrupt, it is having only one ISR address, 0023, which is common for both these things, TI and RI. Okay, which is common for TI and RI. Okay, here you can see for this particular flag, specific address is available. IE0, it will be having a specific ISR address. IE1 is having a specific address of 0013. Okay, TF1 is having address of 001B, but TI and RI both are having a common address of 0023H. Okay. Now, so because of this reason, and one more thing, I have mentioned here, these two are auto cleared. If it is zero, they have occurred, and they are auto cleared in bracket. I have mentioned same thing. I have mentioned here TF1 and TF0. If they are one, they have occurred, and in bracket I have mentioned auto cleared. Can you assume these two are also auto cleared? It is equal to one. See, it is one means that in particular interrupt has occurred. But here I have written auto clear, and I have marked with the cross mark to show that these things are not auto cleared. So to clear these things, the programmer has to write an instruction. Okay, clear with this thing. So you need to remember one thing: TI and RI, they are not the auto clear bits. So the programmer has to clear these bits. And one more thing you need to remember about this TI and RI interrupt flags, that they have a common ISR. What is the address? 0023. Okay. Because of that particular reason, so these two flags, interrupt flags, are having same common address. Because of that reason, they are not auto clear flags. Whereas this TF1, TF0, they have separate ISRs, hence they are auto clear. And here IE1, IE0, they have separate ISR addresses, hence they are what? They can be auto cleared. Okay. See here, why they are not auto cleared? To explain that thing, I have taken the diagram here, ISR diagram here. Consider you are here. Okay, the programmer is here. He is performing normal execution. Okay, after that, he will come to this point. If the interrupt occurs, he will move to the ISR. Okay, serve the interrupt and comes back to that same position. But okay, if TI transmit interrupt has occurred, then you will jump to this particular address 0023. Okay. If RI has occurred, then also you will jump to the same thing. But while moving to this ISR in TF0 and TF1, we will auto clear here itself. Okay, while moving to this thing here, we will write what? TF1 equal to 0. Okay, if TF1 has occurred, while moving to ISR, we will write here TF1 equal to 0. That means while moving to ISR, we will clear. So hence they are called auto clear bits. But why I am not mentioning TI equal to 0 or RI equal to 0 means there is a specific reason, because these two are having a common ISR address. Consider now I am explaining. See, if TI has occurred, okay, TI has occurred, then I will move to this ISR. Okay, ISR, that is what, 0023H address. And if TI equal to 1, I will take only this part of program. Okay, here I have mentioned with the help of braces. So I will execute only this part of program, okay? And from this I will come back. While coming, I will clear TI, okay? Here, as a programmer in ISR, I have mentioned clear TI. So this is not auto clear. So I am purposefully clearing the flag. So I will go through only the part of the program which is available in this braces, and I will come back, okay? Now, second possibility, if RI has occurred, now what I will do? I will move to this ISR part, and I won't execute this upper braces part, and I will execute only this program part which is available in the second braces. So RI is 1, so I will execute this particular part, and I will clear RI, and I will come back. So to perform or to execute this special part of the program, only some part of the program, we need to select TI or RI and clear them. So for that reason, these things, TI and RI, are not auto clear flags. Okay. And you may say, sir, the addresses are starting from 003H, okay, 00B, 0013. So why these specific addresses are given? So there is every reason for why these addresses are given. So I will explain only one thing, okay. 003 means you see internal. Okay, internal ROM. So these things are placed in internal ROM. It will start from all zeros to 07FF. So first address 000, all four zeros are reserved for interrupt. What type of interrupt? Reset vector interrupt. Okay. Okay, so this address 00h reset vector address, that means what is happening, sir? I have explained earlier also, when you start your computer, what will happen? The background has to be set and your icons has to be displayed. For that particular purpose, you will write a particular program. Okay, that is what reset program, reset vector program. So that program is available at what? 000h. So one more thing, to be more clear, at 00h, how many instructions, how many bytes are available? 00, 001, 002, and 003 is reserved for your timer 0. Okay, you can see here this 0003. Simply counting the 0, I will count only this 3. Okay, here for 3, your ISR address of one interrupt 0 is reserved. And how many things are, how many bytes are left? 0, 1, 2, only 3. That means the program is not stored here. Okay, the program is available somewhere. Okay, the address of that particular program is stored in these things. Okay, simply you understand that this 000h, this particular address is reserved for reset vector. That means whenever you start your computer, the background has to set and the icon has to be displayed. For that, a program is available. That program's address will be stored at this 000h. Okay. Now, coming actually to what are these registers. So once again, this IE register is what interrupt enable, which is also SFR. Okay. You see here. You should start from right hand side and you should end with left hand side. Why? So there is a reason that so this will inform you about INT 0, timer 0, INT 1, timer 1, and serial port. So in the sequence, okay, we have seen the sequence 1 2 3 4 5. The same sequence is available here. So you should start from this. What is this, sir? EX not enable external interrupt, which is what? INT 0 enable timer 0. Once again, enable external timer 1. Here, enable timer 1. Enable serial port interrupt. Okay. So when you give 1 here, it becomes enabled. When you give 0, it becomes disabled. Okay. And this new bit is what? ET2, timer 2. So you have two timers, T0 and T1 timers, but there is a third timer. So how you want to introduce the third timer? By taking that timer from second microcontroller. So 8052 is another microcontroller. From that microcontroller, third timer, that is T2 timer. Okay, but for now this is not important for us. Okay, coming to this bit, enable all interrupts. Okay, when it is 1, you will enable all the interrupts. When it is 0, you will disable all the interrupts. That means if I want to access this interrupts, if I want to enable or use this interrupts, definitely it should be 1. If it is 1, then you can, if you set 0 here, it will be disabled. If you place 1 here, it will be enabled. Okay, to understand this thing better, in your homes you will be having a main switch and individual switches, a switch for fan, a switch for light. Okay, so consider these are like your switches of your fans and lights, AC and some other things. But the main switch should be on. When you turn on this switch, then you can switch on and switch off your lights. If it is 0, okay, simply turn off your main switch, and if you play with your switches, you won't get any output here. Okay, so that is the reason. So definitely this enable and all interrupt should be 1, and then you need to go with these particular bits. Okay, now when you are going to use this thing, sir, so I will explain when you are going to use this in next slide. Okay, so here I have written, if you can see this thing, that is okay. Used in ISR structure with RETI, RET I. So I have explained you the difference between normal return and RET I. Okay, return from ISR. Okay, so to explain that, I have taken a diagram here. First, you need to see what is the difference between subroutine and ISR. Subroutine is nothing but you are jumping to some subprogram, executing the subprogram and returning to your return address, okay, which is carried by PC. First thing, okay, that will happen. And the other thing is that when an interrupt has occurred, okay, to service that interrupt, I will move to that interrupt and I will service that interrupt, okay, and I will come back. okay, I will move to that interrupt and service. So while moving to that, what I should do, sir? I should disable all other interrupts. So that thing will happen. So how you can disable? Using interrupt, enable all interrupts. If you are making this zero, all the interrupts will be disabled, and then you will be concentrating only on that particular interrupt, solving the problem, coming back. So while coming back, what you will do, you will use red I. That means what will happen, you will return as well as you will enable all the interrupts. Okay, I have taken the example of our classroom. When I am teaching in class, some students may ask doubt, that is what internal interrupts. Okay, some person comes from outside, so when I am trying to answer the external person, what I will do, I will ask the students, okay, please don't ask anything while when I am dealing with that external person. That means I have disabled all students and I have servicing that external person. So after while returning from that external person, what I will do, now you can ask questions, please concentrate. So that thing is what similar to our ISR and RET I. I have mentioned the diagram here, it is very very clear. So first thing here, I have written something with black ink. Okay, concentrate on that part. Okay, what happens, sir, when you are going for a subroutine, normal sub program, so you will push the contents of PC in stack, go to subroutine. Okay, you will go to this subroutine, solve the program, and using this RET black ink thing, okay, you will use this return and come back. While coming back, what you will do, you will pop the contents of stack and you will come to this PC and execute the program. This is one thing, clear? Now I am going for ISR, which is in blue ink, so concentrate on the blue ink. So while moving to this ISR, all the interrupts are disabled. How to disable them, sir? Using EA pin, enable all interrupts equal to zero means all the interrupts are disabled. Okay, now I will come to this ISR, use this particular program, and I am returning with the help of RET I, RET I. That means I will return as well as re-enable all the interrupts. So I think the difference is very clear. Here I am using, to re-enable all the interrupts, I am using EA bit and setting this EA bit to 1. I hope it is very clear. Okay, coming to next SFR, interrupt priority. Okay, the SFR regarding interrupts is what? Interrupt priority. Okay, it has once again, it is having 8 bits. Okay, now the sequence is same. PX naught means priority of interrupt, external interrupt INT 0, priority of interrupt timer 0, priority of external interrupt 1. Okay, the same sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, what you have seen, and you have PT 2. Once again, there we have seen what this particular bit is reserved for another microcontroller. Okay, so PT 2, now you are not going to use this timer 2. That means T 2, that is what timer 3. We have timer 0, timer 1. If you want third timer, you can get it from external source. That is what another microcontroller. So we are not going to discuss this thing as it is not important in our topic of discussion. Now, see here, consider this number. And I am taking an example to explain in a better manner. All consider this number 00010001. That means, see here, what is happening? If for these bits, if I give 1, it will be having higher priority. If it is 0, it will be having low priority. Okay, now I am comparing these two things. PX naught is compared with PT naught. That means two interrupts have occurred say at same time. PX naught has occurred and PT naught has come to processor. They have interrupted and they are saying, please serve me. So what the processor should do, sir? First it should check that PX naught is having 1, so it will be having high priority. PT naught is having 0, so it will be having low priority. So what the processor should do, sir? He should answer or service this PX naught first and then service PT naught. Okay, because of their individual bits set and reset or 1 and 0, they are having priorities, high priority with PX naught, low priority for PT naught. Then I need to serve both these things, clear? First I will serve PX naught and then I will come to PT naught. Okay, now consider PS, it is having priority 1, so high priority. PX naught, it is also having high priority. Then two persons, okay, I will take an example. Okay, a faculty has come, I am taking class, a faculty has come and a student has come. So my first priority will be for faculty, I will answer him and then I will answer the student. So what will happen, sir? There is a priority. That is okay. If two faculty members come and interrupt me, so which faculty I need to service first? It becomes a dilemma. Okay. So both are of same cadre, both are faculty. So I will be in confusion. So this thing, okay, this thing, once again, the same case may arrive. So two different students have come to our class and they are interrupting me. So which student I need to prefer? No, both are students. So there is a confusion. So that confusion state, when two interrupts are having same priority, see here, I have mentioned here with black ink, okay, PS and PX not, they are having the same priority. So that condition is called tie. Okay, once again, the same thing, PX1 and PT not, they are having same priority. If both occur at a time, that condition is called tie. So you see IPL, okay, this time we have lost IPL. Okay, in IPL, we come across this situation, tie, match tie means two teams have made same runs. So here two interrupts have same priority, that condition is called tie. But how to give the priority, sir? So even in the World Cup, what happened, sir? In World Cup, match has tied, final match, and then they played super over. Once again it was tied. So based on the previous thing, what is the previous thing? Number of boundaries made by a team, considering that thing as default, win was given to England team. Okay, so there should be some default thing. Okay, that is what there should be, default thing, default priority. So if first you should prefer this thing, it should be the one which is having one should be given higher priority, and then zero has to be given priority. When you come across this situation as 1-1 or 0-0 tie, then you need to go with this thing. I will show here. Okay. So then you need to follow this line. See, sir. So it is what, default priority. You should start from this. INT 0 should be given highest priority, then timer 0, then interrupt 1, then timer 1, then serial port. So the priority level starts from INT 0 to serial port. So this will be followed only when there is a tie. Okay, if clear. So first thing you need to notice is what, one is available, that should be given high priority, zero, it should be given less priority. But if two interrupts have occurred and they are having 1-1 or 0-0, then you need to follow the default priority. Okay, so with this topic is complete. Okay, now I will start next topic, that is what, interfacing 4-digit 7-segment display with 8051. So 4-digit means I am displaying some 4 numbers. Okay, I am going to display 4 numbers, so because of that I am saying 4 digits. If you want to display some 5 numbers, you can use 5-digit. If you want to display only two digits, okay, two numbers, if you want to display only two numbers, okay, what you will do, you will use only 2-digit 7-segment display. Concept remains same. Okay, so before going to this thing, where you have seen this 7-segment displays, definitely you have seen this through on auto rickshaws, okay, taxis and digital clocks. Okay, you might have seen this on number of appliances, on your digital balances, many examples are available. Okay, now what is the concept involved, sir? What is the concept available here? See, the processor will display the numbers in a one after the other manner. So it, we see the numbers as constant numbers on a meter. Okay, on a balance meter, if you place some weight, some 500 grams, so the number 500 will be displayed. But in actual, okay, only 500, you are seeing that 500 as a constant number, but internally that is not happening. What is happening, sir? 5 is displayed first, and then 0 is displayed, and then 0 is displayed. Okay, once again, 5 is displayed, 0 is displayed, 0 is displayed, once again 50. So in this random fashion, so in this sequence fashion, the numbers are continuously displayed. That is, they are blinking. Okay, what I can say in the simple words, they are blinking. But because of human persistence of vision, that is what, 100 milliseconds, about 100 milliseconds. So that means something is available for lesser than 100 milliseconds, you will see that image is constant. Okay, that is the thing. So using that biological concept, persistence of vision, that is about 100 milliseconds. So we try to, as a programmer, we try to display that number with lesser than 100 milliseconds delay. That means I will display 5 and I will display 0. Okay, when I'm displaying 0, 5 will not be available. Okay, when I'm displaying second 0, first 0 will not be available. But I'm maintaining the delay between all these things. Once I have displayed 500, okay, then the delay should be lesser than 100 milliseconds so that I can display 500 continuously. Okay, if you want to display a number continuously, the delay should be lesser than 100 milliseconds. That is a simple thing. Okay, now what is 7 segment display, sir? Okay, you are having 7 segments here. Okay, I have already explained this thing when we have come across indexed addressing mode. I hope you remember addressing modes. In that we have specially seen what indexed addressing mode. There we have seen 7 segment display, and there we have seen why ROM is called code memory. Okay, now why it is 7 segment display, sir? Because it is having 7 segments: A segment, B, C, D, E, F, and G. And here you are having dot H, so which is an optional one. In general, we don't use this thing. It's up to you. If you want to use, you can take it. So it becomes 8th segment. But in general, in practice, we won't use this thing. So because of that, we are preferring only 7 segments. Hence the name 7 segment display. Okay. Now, if I want to display something, some number, so the dangerous year you will remember for the rest of your life is what? 2020, the dangerous year. I have taken that same example. Okay, if you want to display 2020, okay, on a display prepared by you, okay, you want to display 4 digits, what you want to display? The current year, dangerous year, 2020. So how to display this thing? If I want to display 2, what should be answer? A should be on, B should be on, and G should be on, E should be on, and D should be on. That means here, once again, you have two methods to activate these segments. One is common cathode technique. That means common cathode means if you want to display, okay, if you want to glow a segment, then provide one to that logic. I provide logic one to this, then A will glow. So that is what common cathode technique is. What active high, if you want to glow the segment, provide one or active high. That is common cathode. Reverse is common anode. Okay, generally we prefer common cathode technique. Now if you want to display two, what the things should be answer? A should glow, B should glow, G should glow, E should glow, and D should glow. So that numbers, that segments will be one, and the remaining will be zero. And H here, it will be by default zero because we are not using this eighth segment. So now you get digit displayed as 2, but to display digit 2, you are not giving 2 to the display. There should be some code for that 2. So to display that thing, what I will take, see here, it is what, 0101, it is 5, and last 4 bits are what, 1011, it is B. So 5B is the code to display 2. Once again, coming to 0, simple. So 0 means except G, all the segments should glow. Clear? Now you can see here, H is by default 0, G is 0, and all others should remain 1 to display 0. And what is the code, sir? Now to get the code, you need to concentrate on higher byte, which is 1, which is 3, and lower byte, all 1s, it means it is F, 3F. Okay, once again 2 and 0. So 2020, for that, if you want to display, the codes you have generated are what? 5B for 2, 3F for 0. Clear? Now, where these codes are stored? So these codes are stored in special part of ROM memory. Okay, you are storing codes in ROM. Hence, you are calling ROM as code memory. Okay, so these 7 segment codes, you can see here, these 7 segment codes, numbers from 0 to 9, are stored in ROM as a table, as a special table. So that table is called what? Lookup table. Lookup means we are referring to that particular table. We are looking into that table for getting these codes. Hence the name is what? lookup table. Okay, so we have taken the example in indexed addressing mode. Indexed addressing mode, we are using what? Two registers. Okay, instead of using one register, we are using two registers. What are they? DPTR2 point starting address of lookup table, and A to carry the distance from this. Okay, to carry the index or the distance from the base address. So DPTR is carrying the base address, A is carrying the index or the distance from the base address. Okay, so at the location 0400, I will store the code of 0. So I am mentioning here 0 tick. So 0 tick mark is what? Code of 0. So what is code of 0, sir? Code of 0 is 3F. Okay, for our understanding, I have placed this 0 tick mark, but 3F will be stored here. Okay, and 0401, code of 1 will be stored. Suppose I want to get the code of 3. So how I need to mention, sir? DPTR starting address, base address is stored in DPTR, and the distance is what? 3, which is stored in A, to get the code. To get the code, what is the program, sir? See this and give importance to this thing. If you understand this part, the whole program is okay, very, very easy. If you understand this part, simple. So DPTR is pointing to 0400, base address is stored in DPTR. Okay, now move A comma hash 03. So if I want to get the code of 3, what I need to do, sir? Simple thing. First step is what? Get the number in A. Okay, if I want to get the code of 3, I am getting 3 in A. Then the magical instruction, what is the magical instruction? Move C A comma at the rate A plus DPTR. That means move the code into A, from where you are getting the code, at the rate A plus DPTR. That means it is pointing to address, okay, which is formed by A plus DPTR. The combined effect that will go for this address, and the code which has to be loaded into A. So what you will get, sir? A is what? 3 tick. That means the code of 3 is taken into A. So what is actually 3, the code of 3? Okay, that is 4F. So accumulator will get 4F into A. Okay, so if you understand this part, everything is very easy. Clear? If I want to get the code of 8, sir, what you will write, sir? Move A comma hash 8, and you will write this instruction, move code A comma at the rate A plus DPTR. So what will happen, sir? Accumulator will get the content, of the code. Code will be stored in A. Here you can see 8 dash. Okay, in our example, I have taken 3. If you want any number, simply place that number, load that number in A. Okay, why I am calling this magical instruction means, see, initially what is available in A? 3. Now using this instruction, you are getting code of 3. So because of that reason, I am mentioning it is a magical instruction. Okay, now to display 4 numbers, definitely you need to have 4 displays. 4 displays are available. So what you need, what you are trying to display? 2020. Okay, now so the codes for that, okay, the 7 segment codes are given through port 1. Okay, the code for 2 is given through this port 1 to this display. Okay, and the port 2 is used to activate the respective digit. Okay, so I am starting from this P2.0. That means port 2 0 bit, port 2 1 bit, up to port 2 7 bit. So I am not interested to use this higher order bits, so I have simply grounded them. That means they will remain as 0. And now if I want to select this particular display, first display, second display, third and fourth display, if I want to select the first display, what I will write, sir, here? Simply 1 0 0 0. Okay, one more thing, you can't activate all the displays at a time. What I have mentioned, sir, in our example, 500. If on digital balance you are seeing 500, okay, 550 gram, okay, to have some clarity, 120 grams. What happens, sir? 1 should come, it will disappear. 2 should come, it will disappear. And 0 should come, and it will disappear. Once again, 1 should come. So continuously 120, 120, they are coming. But because of human persistence, you are seeing 120 grams on digital balance. Okay. Now to activate in a similar manner, what I will do, sir, to display 2 on the first display, I will activate only this 1. Okay. and remaining will remain zero. So what is happening if you are good in electronics? So when you are providing some current to this base, what will happen? The collector emitter current will start flowing from emitter to ground, that is collector. So that means the data which is available in this port 1 will be taken into our display and here it will be displayed. Okay, now if you want to display second number, what you will do, sir? You will select or activate only second display, remaining will be zero. So what will be the code? 0100. Similarly, if you want to activate third display, so what will be the numbers? Are 0010. Okay, if I want to display the last one, so 0001. Okay, I think it is clear. Now I will explain the program. So before going to program, you need to understand the things. What do you need to understand, sir? If you want to display code 2, so what do you need to do? First take DPTR as a base address, get number 2 into A, and using this instruction you will get code. So where the code will be available, sir? With you in 8051 code is available. Okay, now select where you want to display this number 2 on first display. So get this display activated. How you will activate this? Using the code 1000. Activate this one and then load the 7 segment code into P1. That will be given here and it will display number 2. Okay, see, nothing magic in here. Magic here, simply get the number, first thing. Second thing, activate the display, respective display. Okay, first display. So this is the code. Then what you need to do, you need to place the code of the 7 segment on this port P1 that will carry to that respective display. Okay, why I am activating only this one display at a time, sir? If you activate all the displays, consider all 1111, so what will happen, sir? All these four displays, okay, all these four displays will get number 2. So everything, every display is displaying what? Number 2. To avoid that thing, I am purposefully selecting only one display at a time. Okay, now coming to our program, see here, first thing is what? Move DPTR. So you are loading what? Base address into DPTR. Now what I want to display, sir, on first display number 2. So what I will do, sir? Move A comma hash 02H. 02 will be loaded here. Now to get the code of that 2, what I will write, sir? I will write this instruction: move code A comma @A plus DPTR. Okay, what will happen, sir? Here accumulator will get the code of 2. Okay, now what you need to do, sir? You have got 2, code of 2. Now what you need to do? You need to activate the display. Which display you want? First display. So what is the number, sir? See, what is the number, sir, here? So this port is available completely. That means MSB bit is 0, 4 MSB bits are zeros. Okay, and then remaining bits are available. So all zeros, and then you will continue with this number 1000. That means it is 0 and 8. Okay, to activate this display, first display, it is what? 08. Okay, for that reason, what I have taken here? 08. Select the digit. Okay, select first digit, second digit, third digit on display. So first I have selected first digit. Okay, for that the code is 08. Now what I need to do? I need to place the code on port 1. Port 1. So what I will do, sir? I will have got the code and I will place the code on port 1. Okay, that means you are sending the 7 segment code of 2 on port A. And the first digit or the first display will get the number. Okay, and then you need to display that number for some duration. So for that, what I am doing, I am calling a delay program. I have written a delay program somewhere else. Okay, so if I write the delay program once again here, it becomes lengthy. So to avoid that, assume that some delay program is readily available for us. So I am using absolute call. That means the distance, you can understand where absolute call is used, up to 2 kilobytes of distance. Okay, I am using acon and jumping to the delay program. From that delay, I am generating nearly, consider an example, I am generating 5 milliseconds delay. and I will come back and I will start with this program. Now, second thing what you need to display, sir, you want to display 0 on second digit. Now, you want to display 0, you need to take 1, 0, okay, get 0, 0 into A, and then what will happen, sir? Move code A comma at the rate of A plus DPTR, what will happen? The 7 segment code of 0 will be available in accumulator. Then move P2 comma 0 for, why I have taken 0 for, sir? See, see here, now MSB bits are all zeros. I want second display or second digit to be activated. That means others should remain inactive. So all are 0 except this second digit, second display. So it is 1. What is this, sir? 0100 means 4. So higher bits are 0, lower bits are indicating 4. So 04 to select the second digit or second display. Okay. For that, I am loading one 04H. Okay. Now, loading the 7 segment code of 0 into P1, and second digit, second display will display 0. For what time I need to do this, sir? For 5 milliseconds. For that, I am calling a delay. Okay. Now, same thing, sir. Because we are repeating the numbers 2020, the program will remain same. Okay. What you have written for 2 and what you have written for 0, it will remain same. So for 2 and 0, the program will remain same. But you may get confused, sir. You have written the program 2 times. To avoid that confusion, I have taken another example. Instead of 2020, I have taken what? 2018. So if you want to display 2020, so you should go with this number written in blue ink. Okay, here 2020 will be displayed. If you want to display 2018, so already you have written a program for 20, and what you need to, what is remaining, sir? 18. So I want to display 1 here. What I will do, I will take 1 in accumulator, get this instruction. So using this instruction, I'm getting code of 1 into A. Then I need to select what, sir? Third display, third digit. So to get that thing, once again, you need to understand what? Once again, to get this thing, what you need to understand, sir? See, what is where you are displaying, sir? Considering example 2018, so one should be displayed here. That means third digit. So third display should be on. So for that, 0010. That means higher bits are 0, lower bit is 2. 02. Okay. So what should be given in port 2? You should give 02. Okay. Third display will be on. Third digit will be on. You will place the code of 1 into P1 and you will call delay for 5 milliseconds. What will be displayed? 1 will be displayed. If you want 8, you can do the same thing. Okay, with this, the program ends. But you need to do this thing continuously. Okay, so to get this program into infinite loop, I am simply writing what? Sjump. What is this thing, sir? Sjump again. Sjump again. Where it will jump, sir? It will jump to this thing and once again it will start. That means 2018, continuously 2018, 2 will come, wait for 5 seconds, disappears, 0 will come, wait for 5 seconds, disappears, and what, 1 comes, it will stay for 5 seconds, disappears, 8 comes, stay for 5 seconds, disappears. So what is the total delay, sir? 5 plus 5 plus 5, that is totally 20 milliseconds delay. But what is the persistence of human eye? It is about 100 milliseconds. That means if you are maintaining lesser than 100 milliseconds, you will see that numbers as constant. So you will see 2018 is displayed as constant number. But internally what is happening, sir? It is blinking continuously. Okay, you need to remember that. So with this interfacing LED 7 segment display and interrupts part is completed. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Everyone, see, if the concept is clear, if the explanation is clear, that is well and good. But if you have any doubts, even if it is small or a big doubt, it's up to you. You can ask, I will answer. No issue. Students, if the concept is clear, you can inform me. that is well and good. But if you have doubts, even if it is a very small doubt, I will answer. I am here to answer you. If everything is clear, please mention it is clear. If someone is having doubt, please ask. Okay, some students are informing it is very clear. That's okay. That is well and good. Okay, so with this I will, if we have any doubts, you can message me in WhatsApp also. Okay, one more thing, go through our classes continuously. Okay, so all these classes till now what we have seen,